What is going on, everyone? I am Mike. Welcome back to Tech 24/7 TV. I am glad that you're back with me today because we're talking about the iPad Pro and the Magic Keyboard. It's a great piece of hardware. It really enhances the experience. Now, if you've been watching the channel for any amount of time, I have a love of keyboards. I'm always willing to try a different keyboard if it has the ability to enhance the experience. But the problem is that the Magic Keyboard is the reigning champ. And it's unfortunate because it costs so much and it limits access just by the sheer cost of it. Well, last year I went to CES, I saw the Bridge Pro Plus, reviewed it in April when it came out, and quite frankly, it was a really bad experience. The trackpad experience was mediocre at best, and it was nothing like what you experience on the Magic Keyboard. Well, Bridge reached out to me, asked me if I wanted to go ahead and retest the Bridge Pro Plus with a new version of software and iPadOS 14.5, which is in beta. So in today's video, we're gonna go ahead and update the Bridge Pro Plus. We're gonna tell you how it works, how does it work in comparison to the Magic Keyboard, and whether or not you should purchase it for $169. Let's get started. Just to make sure that we are on the same page, this video is not paid for by Bridge. This video is not sponsored by Bridge. I bought this keyboard from Amazon with my own money. And if you wanna pick it up for yourself, I'll leave a link in the description below. But they are watching this video at the same exact time that you are watching this video. So there's no editorial control whatsoever. Now, second thing, if you like Apple rumors and Apple news, I launched a new podcast with my friend Holden. It is called Network Podcast. Really love for you to check it out. Let me know what you think about it. I'll put a link down in the description below right next to this. Now, the Bridge Pro Plus is available for the 12.9 inch and the 11 inch version. This is $169 for the 12.9 inch version, which I'll be testing today. And this is all metal. It's very hefty, to say the least. It still has the same design. It doesn't look any different. Still has these hinges that you see here on the left-hand and bottom right-hand corner. Some people are a fan of them, some people are not. I necessarily don't mind them. And it does come with a magnetic sleeve, maybe, for the back of your iPad if you don't wanna worry about scratching that. For our test, we're gonna take a 12.9 inch iPad Pro, which is running iPadOS 14.5, update the software on the Bridge Pro Plus to the most unreleased version of the Bridge Connect software, and see how it functions in comparison to a 11 inch iPad Pro that's running iPadOS 14.5. Now, in order to get this software on your device, you have to be able to run iPadOS beta 14.5. So you have to be registered either in the public beta program or as a developer. Second, if you want to apply towards Bridge's beta program, you can, which they'll send you a version of Test Flight, which contains the newest unreleased version of the app running with that software. So you'll need to go ahead and update that. So I went ahead and paired my iPad. I'm charging it. It does, or the keyboard does need to be charged while you're doing the software update. And I'm going to install it right now. All right, with a little magic, unlock and reconnect. Start update. We're crossing fingers. I really hope that this works, fingers crossed, because this should be a more accessible product, right? At the previous price, I think was $229 or $219. It was way more expensive than it should have been. And now that it is down to $169, I think it's a lot more competitive. Many more people, I think, will be able to use a keyboard with their iPad and make it their everyday computer. Now that I've updated the Bridge Pro Plus to the unreleased version from Bridge Connect, the Bridge Pro Plus is showing up as version 2.0, which is different than when I first plugged it in. It was version 1.1. That is interesting, to say the least. So now both these iPads are on, and wow. Okay, so wow is a good tone. You know, the three finger swipe up, just kind of it's pretty snappy. And this is a complete change from where I used it last. Now let's go ahead and let me pull up the gestures for the iPad Magic Keyboard, but you can just search for trackpad gestures for iPad and it lists out all the different gestures. So one finger click, yep, that works on the Magic Keyboard as well as the Bridge Pro Plus. Swipe up to access the menu. Oh, there's nothing there to go ahead and access. Let's open something up. We'll put it in memory. Now, if I want to go ahead and minimize this app. Yep. So that works as you would expect. Swipe up to close the app works. Let's see here. Now I can bring in an app by doing a three finger swipe left to right or right to left. I actually have to go along the bottom here. Here to two finger swipe left. Yep. So far, so good. Let's see here. Can we wake the iPad? Wake the iPad works. Let's go to Twitter, or sorry, The Verge, and two finger swipe down, and swipe up. Two finger swipe up and swipe down works here as it does on the iPad or on the Magic Keyboard as well. Click an item and drag. Okay, so I'm going to take this item here, Instacart, which is great for picking groceries, and drag that. That works as expected. And let's go here. And here we're going to do Headspace. Yep, that works as expected. Swipe up, that works as well. So if I have an app open, if I pull down with one finger, that exposes the dock. Let's see here. If I do the go home, two fingers, go home. Swipe down. Oh, what was that here? Let's try that again. Two finger swipe down, search. Yep, that's looking good. And let's see here. If I do long press, get long press there. And here we have long press functioning the same. So one finger go home, I'm gonna swipe down and that goes right back. Now I'm just looking at this. Let's go from page to page. All right, so now that we have the Files app open here, I'm gonna push one finger in and the app comes in, app slides out. This is actually really good. Two finger gestures. This is the same, right? There's no difference. It's maybe a hair smoother on the iPad, but I would say it's not necessarily perceivable. What other gestures can we do? Open Notification Center, that's gonna work. Open Control Center, that is gonna work. Yep, that's just a kind of a standard gesture. Scroll left to right, we already demonstrated. Ooh, pinch to zoom, that's a good one. So let's go to Photos. All right, Photos, and here, we'll do this photo. This is super fast, super smooth. Let's see here. Let's switch between apps. And as soon as it's up, three fingers, swipe. Wow, that's a huge difference. Let me try that in Maps. So let's do pinch to zoom in Maps. Yeah, that's the same thing here. Yep. Let's find out what other features we want to use. Today view, open search, home screen. Secondary click, that's a good one. Okay, so we're gonna go home. Using two fingers to click on an app and get the contextual menu, that works as well. After using this for about 10 minutes, I think I have a pretty good baseline. I used this extensively last year, 2020, for about 3 months. And that is where I'm kind of drawing my comparison against. This is night and day difference. From a functional perspective, I think that all of the gestures work like for like between the Magic Keyboard and the Bridge Pro Plus. There might be just a hair of latency inside of with the Bridge Pro Plus. I don't know if that's final, but it's definitely not like lag. I wouldn't call it that at all. It's way better than it was, and it's actually kind of enjoyable to use. It feels really good in this iteration, I could be honest with you. At $169, if the functionality maintains as it is with this beta, I would say that $169, it's a very good buy. I like the keyboard on the Bridge Pro Plus. I've come accustomed to typing on the Magic Keyboard, but that's just me. Some people don't like the chiclet style keys that are on the Magic Keyboard, and I think this is a good alternative. And the best part about this is that it's $169 for the Bridge Pro Plus in the 12.9 inch version. If you have been holding off getting a keyboard, I would say that maybe just wait a little bit while longer, because this is not out yet. The software version is not out for Bridge. You have to wait for Apple to release iPadOS 14.5, and then Bridge has to release that update to the App Store. So it does take, you know, a little bit of time. But I would say that this initial comparison between the Magic Keyboard here and the Bridge Pro Plus is almost like for like. I am going to continue to test more. I do think that Apple's got something up their sleeves where I would call it maybe a bigger Magic Keyboard, because at the price point of $300, I would almost think that Apple is going to drop the price and allow manufacturers like Bridge to come in at a lower price to address more of the market. Now, that's just my opinion, and this isn't proven yet, but we'll see what happens when Apple has their spring event on March 23rd, or at least that's what the rumor says. Now, let me know if you have any questions down in the comments below. My name is Mike. I'm glad that you joined me today. Stay safe out there, and I will talk to you in the next one.